أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي الصلاة حي الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اتقوا الله عباد الله اتقوا الله فالتقوى أربح المكاسب وأجل المواهب قال جل شأنه واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون أما بعد my brothers is reported in Bukhari under the chapter title باب من دعا برفع الوباء والهمة the chapter the one who supplicates to have the pandemic or the fever to be lifted On the authority of Aisha radiallahu anha, that when the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam made hijrah from Mecca to Al-Madinah, it was a place, Al-Madinah, it was a place where a contagious fever had spread amongst the Muhajirun. So Abu Bakr and Bilal were those people who had a very high fever, may Allah be pleased with them both. So Aisha radiallahu anha said, فَدَقَلْتُ عَلَيْهِمَا I visited them both and I said, Ya Abati, كيف تجدك ويا بلال How are you my father and how are you feeling بلال And they would give her a normal answer But Abu Bakr's fever got worse radiallahu anhu Remember my brothers This is still an early stage in Al-Madinah Islam has not been established yet in the peninsula The religion has not been complete And Abu Bakr says something to his daughter Because this shows you the certainty and the iman that he had, radiallahu anhu. He was not guaranteed, and he knew, he was not guaranteed whether he was going to live, whether he was going to live long enough to see that Islam would spread. So he answered once when he was asked the question again, How are you? His daughter said to him, radiallahu anha. He said, Kullum ri'im musabbahum fi ahlih. Every day you wake up amongst your family. Maybe everything is normal. وَالْمَوْتُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ الصِّدِّيقُ وَالْمَوْتُ أَدْنَى مِنْ شِرَاكِ نَحْنِ But death is closer to him than his own shoelaces. Bilal رضي الله عنه also feared death, even though he has not established himself as the muadhin of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the way that we know him today. He too hasn't seen Islam being completed. He too hasn't seen the Fatah of Mecca. He too hasn't climbed on top of the Kaaba and made adhan. Yet he too feared that his life would not be long enough to see this. Aisha radiallahu anha told the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then supplicated for the situation that they found in Medina. He said, Allahumma, حبب إلينا المدينة أو الله make مدينة beloved to us كحبنا مكة أو أشد just like we love مكة or even more وصححها make it a place where we find health and remove this fever from us وبارك لنا في ساعها ومدها and bless us in its ساع and bless us in its مد Bless us in our produce, bless us in our economy. وَانْقُلْ هُمَّهَا فَاجْعَلْهَا بِالْجُحْفَةِ And take it away from us and place it in Juhfa, close to the mushrikun. My brothers, today we are in a situation which is no different. Death is closer to us than we think. Our economy has become extremely fragile. And most of us, we don't know whether our Islam has been completed or not. What will happen if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to take us today? What will happen to our future generations if this pandemic spreads even more and we are destroyed? How do we know? We know because what was good for them is good for us. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu is telling us an important message which lives until today. كُلُّ مْرِئِمْ مُسَبَّحٌ فِي أَهْلِهِ You are with your family one moment, everything is fine, but the next, it could be the very next moment, وَالْمَوْتُ أَدْنَى فِي مِنْ شِرَاكِ أَهْلِهِ That death is closer and we don't realize it. Death is certain, but we don't see it. One of the Imams of the Salaf, Bilal ibn Sa'd, Rahimahullah, he said, رُبَّ مَسْرُورٍ مَغْبُونَ وَلَا يَشْعُرُ It could be that a person is happy, but he is deluded and he doesn't realize it. He is enjoying his life, but he is in loss and he doesn't even know it. يَأْكُلْ وَيَشْرَبْ وَيَدْحَقْ He eats and he drinks and he laughs just like life is normal. وَقَدْ حُقَّ لَهُ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ But it is written in the book of Allah, أَنَّهُ مِنْ وُقُودِ النَّارِ That he is soon to become the fuel of the fire. My brothers, how many people entered into this dunya with nothing and they will leave it helpless? But barakah and goodness, my brothers, barakah and goodness is in having tawakkul in Allah, reconnecting with Him correctly and taking the appropriate measures. Don't think I don't need to wear a mask. Don't think I don't need to distance. Don't think I don't need to wash my hands. Because in this narration from the Prophet ﷺ, his attitude towards the fever was to take his measures and to get closer to Allah, to supplicate to Him, to increase in worship, to have a firm base in tawakkul and asking Allah for cure and protection. He took his worldly measures and he didn't take them for granted. In this hadith, my brothers, it is clear that even the best of the Muslims can be destroyed by a plague. These are the finest of the muhajirun who thought that they were going to die of an illness, who thought that they perhaps won't live to see Islam spread. These people knew that death was close to them, and when they saw the pandemic and when they saw the fever, it actually increased them with their connection with Allah. It actually increased them with thinking about the akhirah. So what makes us feel safe, my brothers? What guarantee do we have? Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَالسُّنَّةِ أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ وَتُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ إِنَّ رَبِّي لَغَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ الحمد لله الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونسح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده فصلوات الله عليه والسلام وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد my brothers we have now entered into a new month and a new Islamic Hijri calendar And this month that we have entered in is the month of Allah, the month of Muharram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran that He has created the heavens and the earth and He has made an annual year, 12 months. But from those 12 months, minha arba'atun hurum, ذلك الدين القيم, from four of those 12 are sacred. And that is the upright religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided us to. ذلك الدين القيم فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم How is it upright? in these months, my brothers, increase in doing good deeds, because you have no other religion except Islam, which tells you that. In these 4 months, decrease in your bad deeds. Think about your actions, because bad deeds are worse in these 4 months. This is the upright religion. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Afdul siyam ba'da Ramadan shahrullahi Muharram." The best fasting after the fasting of the month of Ramadan is the month of Muharram. Muharram is a month of worship of Allah. So increase in salat, increase in siyam, increase in sadaqah. Next week we will have the 9th and the 10th, where the Prophet ﷺ said, if a person fasts on the 10th, he will get a year's of expiation of his deed. Muharram is also a month of salvation. It is a month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa and Nuh and others from the prophets alayhim salam. So seek closeness for yourself, my brothers. Seek a salvation for yourself. Seek a salvation from the troubles and the difficulties that you are facing by getting closer to Allah in this month. My brothers, from the aqidah of Ahlus Sunnah, is that there is ijma from the salaf of this ummah that we are forbidden to speak out against the Muslim rulers, irrespective of how bad the situation is, or even if we think the situation is good. Abu Darda, radiallahu anhu, the famous companion, he said, "Iyakum wa la'na al-wulat. Iyakum wa la'na al-wulat. Beware of cursing or insulting the rulers. Fa'inna la'nahum haliqa. Because insulting them shaves off your good deeds. Wa bughduhum al-aqira. And hating them is pointless. Hating them will not bring about any benefits." So they asked him, radiallahu anhu, "What do we do if we see something bad?" He said, radiallahu anhu, "Fasbiru." Remain patient. But what if, my brothers, what if the Muslim ruler is not the Muslim ruler of your country, and he is in another country in the Middle East or somewhere else? Is it now then permissible for us to speak against him because he is not our Muslim ruler? My brothers, a person may feel that they want to criticize what is happening in the Middle East, but look what Al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, narrates in his tariq, that Aun As-Sahmi advised Abu Umam, "La tasubbu al-hajjaj, fa innahu alayka amir, wa laysa ala bi amir." Do not revile Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi, even though that you are in Sham. And Hajjaj was the mayor of Iraq at that time. The understanding of the Salaf is that if he is Muslim and he is a ruler, even if he is not your ruler, it is not allowed for us to speak against the rulers. لا تسبوا الحجاج. My brothers, politics in this world is creating a great deal of fitna, and is creating a great deal of confusion for the Muslims. But there is no fitna worse today than the fitna of Hajjaj ibn Yusuf. He killed companions. He killed imams. There is no fitna that is worse than the mihna of Imam Ahmad, when he was trialed with people saying that the Quran was created, but he remained firm. What did the Salaf do? Did they go on revolting? Did they create a revolution? Did they take to speaking out against the rulers? No. The advice unanimously from the Salaf: remain patient, worship Allah, supplicate to Allah for rectification, advise them if you are able to, bring about reformation in the correct manner. This is not a negative view where we say that we do not do anything. We do things according to the correct manhaj of Ahlus Sunnah. Imam Al-Barbahari said in Sharh Sunnah, who was Imam Al-Barbahari? Imam Al-Barbahari, he was one of the Imams of the Salaf. And he himself actually was close to the rulers. But then when that ruler passed away that he was close to, another ruler came who didn't like him very much. He was an innovator. So he punished Imam al-Barbahari and he put him in house arrest. What was his attitude? One moment he was close to the rulers and advising them. The next moment we are seeing policies which are against what is correct according to the people of ilm at that time. He didn't speak out. In actual fact, he has a book which is a cornerstone when it comes to the manhaj and the aqidah of Ahlus Sunnah. He said, rahimahullah, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الرَّجُلُ, if you see a man, يَدْعُو عَلَى السُّلْطَانِ فَأَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ صَاحِبُ الْهَوَىٰ, If you see a person speaking against, insulting, reviling the Muslim rulers, then realize that he is a person of innovation. He is a person of desires. He is a person of deviation. وَإِذَا سَمِعْتَ الرَّجُلُ And if you hear of a man, يَدْعُوا لِلسُّلْطَانِ He actually supplicates for the ruler. He supplicates for rectification. بِالصَّلَاحِ فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ صَاحِبُ السُّنَّةِ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ My brothers, our religion is complete. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ Salvation and all salvation is in it. It even tells us what to do in a pandemic 1,442 years after the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because it is the truth from Allah. So we return back to him. Ahead of us is a month, which is the month of Allah. Make istighfar to him. Take your religion seriously. Refrain from doing something which will not benefit you. And even if you see something which saddens you, realize that death is certain. It is closer than you think. Prepare for it wisely by doing that which will benefit you. By doing and acting upon those things which you have control over, and not to worry and talk about those things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given you dominion over, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change in the world of politics, in the world, because this is His dominion. My brothers, Allah has commanded us that we send peace and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was our role model, and there was none better and more sincere than him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين We ask you, O Allah, O Allah, help Islam and the Muslims. We ask you, O Allah, help Islam and the Muslims. O Allah, protect Islam and the Muslims. O Allah, give us an aid and a solution for all of our problems. O Allah, guide us in our errors. O Allah, you are Al-Fattah, you are Al-Alim. Give us unity on the truth and guide this ummah as a whole. O Allah, help the Muslims in Gaza. They are being bombarded with only you knowing what is happening with them. Bring relief to them. Help them, remove them away from their oppression. O Allah, help our Muslim rulers and our scholars and the people in authority. O Allah, give help and aid to the weak and the ill. Give ease to those people who are suffering wherever they are. Bring a solution to our problems. Guide our youth. Keep us firm on your correct path. O Allah, have mercy on those people who have passed away and preserve those who remain. رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ مَا يَصِفُونَ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ